Welcome back today, Rocket Science. I'm Adam Balkin. Activism has long played a role in wildlife conservation, and one award-winning filmmaker is doing his part to bring awareness to the effect of the global illegal animal trade on the biosphere and how science can save us from ourselves.
In a high-tech covert operation, the production crew for the film Racing Extinction went undercover using surveillance technology to infiltrate global black markets to bring light to the illegal animal trade.
99% of the scientists are saying that if we don't do something, we're gonna all be in trouble in the next 50 to 100 years, if not already. So the idea is that we wanted to make a movie to wake people up.
Stevens and his team have already won acclaim for their Oscar-winning documentary, The Cove, about the mass poaching of dolphins off the coast of Japan. In their latest film, they mount a two-prong attack, taking aim at the global illegal animal trade and documenting the link between carbon emission and species extinction, while acknowledging the role scientists play in the planet's salvation.
Scientists are crucial in solving this crisis because they are the ones that are doing the studies. They are the ones that are telling us, guys, wake up. So they're really, really crucial to explaining to the world what is really going on. And by making a film, we try to use those scientists' voices as mouthpieces to kind of communicate that. Technology is one of the most important issues. Solar technology is just getting better and better and better. Wind technology is getting better and better. We need to rely on that. We can't rely on people going in, digging up coal, digging up fossil fuels, and spewing it out into the world anymore.
Racing Extinction is playing in select theaters and will make its television premiere on the Discovery Channel December 2nd.
Now, it may sound crazy, but New York City has more than 500 miles of coastline, yet many of its residents have never ventured to the shoreline. But that's not true of some of the city's students who made their way to the New York Aquarium for a behind-the-scenes tour designed to provide a greater understanding of natural conservation. Stephanie Simon has a story.
It's a first for many of these students who are out of their element, meeting some denizens of the deep who are likewise out of their element, housed at the New York Aquarium.
I love sharks and I don't really get to see that much sharks.
It was great that a lot of animals like the sea lions know like a lot of tricks.
The students on this tour are temporarily being housed in the New York City homeless shelter system. The city's Department of Homeless Services partners with the New York Aquarium to make this educational visit possible.
To come here to the aquarium to have a wonderful time, to be entertained, but of course to be educated, to learn about conservation. That's a big issue right now with global warming, and we want the kids to understand that issue.
The aquarium's director says the tours are more than just a chance for kids to see cool animals. It's about inspiring future conservation leaders.
We believe that we serve as an inspirational inroad for kids to get in, to figure out that science is fun and engaging. And through our work in our classrooms, we see about 12,000 kids in our classrooms. Through the use of the aquarium with teachers as a school trip, we see about 120,000 kids. That's a vast number of kids that are being given that moment that may change their lives, and in some kids will.
The students were given a lesson about the fish housed in the main facility and then moved outside to meet the aquarium's penguins, seal, walrus, and were captivated by the performance of a couple of sea lions.
Well, I was happy that I got to see some sharks, and I was really amazed about those big fish that I saw inside. And the sea lion show was pretty great.
And in terms of a STEM career, at least for this student, he's keeping his options open.
If my rap career doesn't work, then I'll just work at the aquarium.
For It Ain't Rocket Science, I'm Stephanie Simon.
In referring to the search for a job, some applicants are apt to quip, it's a zoo out there. But a group of high schoolers in Ohio see that reference in a whole different light. We stopped in at Columbus Zoo School to see how these scientists in training are getting a head start on a career in the sciences.
These students are doing more than paying a visit to their local zoo. They're ditching the traditional classroom for a shot at a hands-on, practical experience.
The coolest part is like those small little moments where you just get like a little bit closer to the animal, or you actually have to hold an animal, and it's like something that you would never get to experience if like you were in a normal science classroom.
We all hang out and have a great time. It's like there's a pretty good chemistry in the room, and I think that makes it pretty special.
Zoo School at the Columbus Zoo and Aquarium is a two-year co-curriculum program where students spend half their school day attending classes at the zoo. It's run on a traditional public school calendar, and students must go through a competitive application process to be considered for one of 25 spots. Once accepted, students spend their time focusing on science-related research and developing skills that will help them when entering the STEM workforce.
We are a career tech program, so we're all about giving the students the skills to then become employable and go out and work in these fields later on.
We have more freedom here to like talk and like share like our experiences and like things that we've done. I feel like I'm actually like working on something that we'll do, like, is actually a product and actually is worth something.
I like the social aspect of it. I got to meet a lot of new different people from like different schools and stuff that I never would have been able to meet before.
Students here plan on attending college and pursuing careers in conservation, marine biology, and veterinary science.
All right, we have to take one more quick break, then coming up.
It's billed as the greatest show and tell on earth. We'll check out what this year's World Maker Faire has to offer. And one company in North Carolina says that manufacturing at its facility is beyond conveyor belts and assembly lines, as it hopes to attract future employees. And at the University of Texas, it's the Super Bowl of academic solar technology. Students are competing for top honors in the U.S. Department of Energy's Solar Decathlon. To find hands-on science, technology, engineering, and math opportunities in your community, visit theconnectory.org, made possible by Time Warner Cable's Connect a Million Minds.